latest development here in Phnom Penh, you have agreed to set up a joint committee for electoral reform. Are you positive? You think there will be a breakthrough?
I hope so. I don't know the intention of the other side. But as for us, we want to reach a political and peaceful solution. We want the holding of new elections as soon as possible.
Well, before you agreed to this joint committee,
yes,
did you detect any concession from Hun Sen?
Yes, yes, we have received signals, we have received some indications that the election could be held a little bit before the normal end of the term, which is July 2018. So it could be held before.
But you have been demanding an election before the end of this year.
Yes.
So but you have considered?
We have to make some concessions also. Actually, we would like to have an election in 6 months
yes.
or at the end of this year.
Yes.
This would be excellent for us. But we cannot have everything that we wanted. So we will be a little bit flexible.
Yes.
And we hope that the ruling party of Mr. Hun Sen will also show some flexibility.
So you're not demanding the resignation of Prime Minister Hun Sen?
I think to be very to the point, we would be happy with the early election, because we know that after the next election, if they are organized properly, Mr. Hun Sen would go anyway.
Do you think you can run the country better than Hun Sen?
Of course.
Why? How?
Because this country is going down the drain. The people are not happy. They suffer. They suffer from the fact that the current regime, Mr. Hun Sen's family, cronies, they are just sending the country to private, to foreign interests.
Mr. Hun Sen's influence has been so deep-rooted. He has run this country for 28 years at least.
29.
How do you uproot such an entrenched power base?
I think that a few days or a few weeks before the fall of many dictators, people could have made the same remark about the fall of Ceausescu, the fall of Saddam Hussein, the fall of Mubarak, the fall of Ben Ali. Many people say, oh, those dictators have been in power for decades. So they will stay in power forever. I think this kind of reasoning is wrong. On the contrary, the longer they stay in power, the shorter the time they will remain in power.
The young people of Cambodia are more outspoken. They now express their opinions openly.
Yes.
Well, before, when I came to Cambodia, say, 10, 12 years ago, they would not even talk privately against the government. But now they're quite open about it. Why so?
Because this is the new generation. 70% of the population are under 30. So they are more educated. Therefore, they are more critical, more demanding, and they want to change the leadership of the country. Because since they were born, some 30 or less than 30 years ago, they have only seen Mr. Hun Sen as Prime Minister.
There's only one Prime Minister
yes,
in their life?
In their life.
So far?
Yes. But they are more educated. They have access to the internet. They travel as migrant workers, especially to Thailand. They see and they compare Cambodia with neighboring countries.
Mm-hmm.
Neighboring countries, they have changed their leadership
mm-hmm.
on a regular basis.
Mm-hmm.
It is why neighboring countries are more developed.
Mm-hmm.
People are more happy.
Mm-hmm.
But any country that keeps the same leadership for 30, 40 years
mm-hmm.
are the most backward countries, like North Korea,
mm-hmm.
Some African countries
mm-hmm.
With the leadership such as Mr. Mugabe
mm-hmm.
and all kind, you know, of dictators. So the young people, they understand that we need new ideas, a new inspiration, a new leadership.
Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, the social media, you think have any role to play in what you call the big change?
Yeah, definitely. The new generation, they are better informed and they can mobilize
mm-hmm.
Quickly
mm-hmm.
Thanks to Facebook
mm-hmm.
Mainly.
Mm-hmm.
And the opposition does not have any access to the television, to any modern broadcast media.
You're not allowed on TV here at all?
No, no, no.
No one can interview on TV?
No, no.
Newspapers cannot interview you?
No, TV is the monopoly of the ruling party for 30 years.
Not even 1 minute?
Not even 1 minute.
So they, when you speak publicly, they do not
never
report it?
Never, they ignore. They,
uh-huh.
they ignore us. But even so, people, supporters, they know what we are doing, what we are fighting for. It's mainly through Facebook.
The leader of the opposition, the most prominent enemy of Hun Sen, aren't you afraid of being murdered, being killed, being assassinated?
I am aware since the very beginning when I committed myself to fight for justice for my country and
mm-hmm.
to oppose the current regime. I have only three possible fates.
Mm-hmm.
Being killed,
mm-hmm.
being in jail,
mm-hmm.
being forced into exile.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I have known the first two.
The first two you have already encountered.
But, yeah, but I am aware
yes.
that the three possibilities can arise anytime.
Mm-hmm. What if Hun Sen asks you to form a coalition government with him? Let's have a national unity government, let's make peace, come on, we know each other, working together better than fighting each other. Are you going to agree to that?
Hun Sen has asked me a different thing
mm-hmm.
at our last meeting
yes.
in September.
What did he say?
He asked me to prepare an amnesty law for him.
Wow. Meaning that he expected you to become prime minister and...
No, not that clear. But he realizes that he cannot remain in power forever.
Mm-hmm.
He needs to think about a smooth evolution.
Mm-hmm.
So he asked an amnesty law that would protect three persons.
Mm-hmm.
The, without mentioning any name.
Yes.
He said the president of the Senate, the president of the National Assembly
mm-hmm.
and the prime minister. So the president of the Senate is Mr. Chia Sim,
mm-hmm.
who is the president of the ruling CPP.
Mm-hmm.
The president of the National Assembly
mm-hmm.
is Mr. Heng Samrin,
mm-hmm.
who is the honorary president of the CPP.
Mm-hmm.
And the prime minister is Mr. Hun Sen,
mm-hmm.
the vice president of the CPP.
Mm-hmm.
So he asked for amnesty for these three top leaders.
But you are in the opposition, you cannot issue amnesty. How, what did he ask you?
No, he thinks ahead.
Uh-huh.
He told me that we, ruling party,
mm-hmm.
we cannot initiate such a law.
Yeah.
But if you, mm-hmm. opposition party,
mm-hmm.
you initiate such a law,
mm-hmm.
we, ruling party, we would support it.
I see. A strange request to an opposition leader.
This means that things are changing
mm-hmm.
in Cambodia.
What do you say to him when he said that?
Of course, yes.
He said yes?
Yes.
So you're colluding with him?
for the sake of Cambodia, to preserve peace.
So you agree to forgive him if you become the Prime Minister, you are going to pardon him
for
all the things that you said he has done to the country?
I think it's understandable that he wants his life to be preserved.
Mm-hmm.
He wants his freedom to be preserved.
Mm-hmm.
He wants his dignity to mm-hmm. be preserved.
Mm-hmm.
He wants at least a portion of his wealth to be preserved.
Mm-hmm.
And there are examples throughout the world that this could be given
mm-hmm.
in order to ensure
mm-hmm.
a smooth transition.
That means he's realizing that the end is near for him.
Mm? Yes. And that his desire to found a dynasty, I think it is mm-hmm. irrealistic.
Mm-hmm.
He cannot be like Kim Il-sung, you know, mm-hmm. with the mm-hmm. children, Kim Jong-il, Kim Jong-un.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It is impossible. Mm-hmm. In the modern world, it is impossible.
Mm-hmm. And do you have anything that you ask him for pardon? Are you still under any investigations, or would you be subjected to any punishment if some of the cases are raised against you?
Any independent investigation would clear me mm-hmm. of any charge, so I'm not concerned. Mm-hmm. Those who are concerned are those who did commit crimes,
mm-hmm.
which is not my case.
Mm-hmm. So you are really confident that change is just around the corner for
yes,
Cambodia?
Yes, inevitable.
Mm-hmm.
I'm very confident.
Mm-hmm.
The wind of freedom
mm-hmm.
blows all over the world,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
blows stronger and stronger.
Mm-hmm.
And this wind of freedom
mm-hmm.
will reach Cambodia very soon.
So you're preparing for the day that a new dawn
yes.
will come to Cambodia, and that you will be right in the center?
No, the Cambodian people will be right in the center.
Where would you be in that landscape, the new Cambodia? Where would you stand?
We will see, because this is not very important. For me, important is to bring about a democratic change in Cambodia.
And you don't have to be Prime Minister. You don't have to lead the charge.
Not necessarily, you know. Any person can be replaced,
mm-hmm.
but your country cannot be replaced.
Mm-hmm.
You have only one country.
เป็นการตอบคำถามที่ต้องบอกเลยครับว่าหลายคำตอบคาดไม่ถึงครับแต่อย่างไรก็ตามการเมืองกัมพูชากำลังถึงจุดผันแปรที่มีความสำคัญอย่างยิ่งคนไทยเราที่ติดตามการเมืองกัมพูชาต้องเฝ้ามองครับทั้งฮุนเซนทั้งสมรังสีจะตกลงกันได้ไหมจะมีทางปรองดองกันได้หรือเปล่าและการเมืองกัมพูชาต่อไปนี้จะมีความโปร่งใสชัดเจนฮุนเซนพร้อมจะลงพร้อมจะต่อรองกับสมรังสีหรือว่าสมรังสีกำลังจะเล่นเกมอะไรหรือว่าฮุนเซนกำลังหลอกล่อให้สมรังสีตกเข้าไปในจุดอับที่ท้ายที่สุดฮุนเซนอาจจะหัวเราะดังกว่าสมรังสีก็ได้แต่ทั้งหมดนี้คือไทม์ไลน์สุทธิชัยหยุ่นทุกสัปดาห์วันอาทิตย์เวลาอย่างนี้แหละครับจะพบปะกับเรื่องราวที่ทีมข่าวต่างประเทศของเราไปสัมภาษณ์ไปเจาะไปวิเคราะห์เพื่อนำมารายงานให้ท่านทราบผมจะจับเอาประเด็นร้อนที่สุดของสัปดาห์และจะติดตามสัมภาษณ์คนที่น่าสนใจในเรื่องราวที่เกี่ยวกับต่างประเทศแต่ที่มีผลสืบเนื่องต่อประเทศไทยให้ได้ชมกันทุกสัปดาห์อย่างนี้ครับติดตามนะครับไทม์ไลน์สุทธิชัยหยุ่นครับสวัสดีครับ